Hi guys, welcoming you all to my YouTube channel Clear Cut Concepts. So in this video we are going to solve this year question paper January 2021 paper 2 mathematics. We are planning to solve mathematics 30 questions. So in the first part I'm running first 15 questions. In the second part, we will get next 15 questions. Yes, let's get started. So, the question number 31. Which of the following is most appropriate strategy for introducing the concept of multiplication of two decimal numbers in the middle school? In the middle school, elementary school, we are covering 6th to 8th. Okay, so what is the best strategy for applying it to the children? Okay, option 1, multiplication as repeated addition should be emphasized. So this is in the primary level. Already we taught in the 5th standard or 4th standard like that, not for the middle. Multiplication as the inverse of division should be emphasized. Not necessary. Here we are explaining how to multiply two decimal numbers. Okay. Next, algorithm should be introduced. Algorithm in the higher classes only. Okay. Fourth one, the process should be visually represented. Visually represented. So this is a correct method. So in 6th to 8th, we are doing the activities. Activity through, we are teaching the children. So, I have done one activity also for rational numbers in the same manner. So, this is the method. Visually, they are seeing and they are doing by hands-on activity means it will help them to understand too fast. So, the process is, this one is correct. The process should be visually represented. Our activity method, hands-on activity means we give the importance to that strategy. Okay. Come to the next question. 32. Which of the following is a narrow aim? Narrow aim of teaching mathematics. So what is a narrow aim? Okay, that is the least. We are considering least aim. Okay. So what is that? To make a student proficient in handling numbers and number operations. Okay. So not math is not only handling the numbers. I think this is not correct. To develop student generalization abilities. Yeah, this one is correct. We are giving example. Example through we are teaching how to generalize the concept. That is inductive method. Okay. So example through we are teaching how to generalize the abilities. To encourage systematic reasoning, this is also correct. Ability to argue the truth and the falsity of the statement, this is also correct. So which one is the narrow aim? I am teaching only math means I am teaching only number. That is the wrong way. Okay, that is the narrow aim of teaching. Come to the next question. 33. Question number 33 is, which of the following is most appropriate strategy for teaching students to solve mathematical problems? Okay, what is the correct strategy? So the teacher should begin by explaining the steps required for obtaining the solution. No, this is not a correct way. Okay, we are not start with the questions with the steps. Okay, not correct. Students should be encouraged to view problem from the many perspectives. Okay. So we have to give the student to the question. The question to the students. They can use many ways. Different students are using different methods. And then they made a mistake. After that, we can guide them how to do the correct one. Okay, different perspectives they can apply. This one is correct. Guess and verify approach should be strictly discouraged. No, we can't discourage the child. They can guess and then they can apply, they can verify the answer also. The list of formula required to solve in the given set of problems should be provided. This is also not necessary. Okay. So the correct one is, students should be encouraged to view problem from many perspectives. Okay. 34. I'm missing here. I'm scrolling from elements. 34. Identify the incorrect statement from among the following. Which one is incorrect? So whenever you are seeing different means, underline the line. Which is incorrect? Okay. Mathematical communication involves precise use of language. Okay. This one you can expect. Conjectures do not have utility in constructing mathematical knowledge. Okay. What is a conjectures? Conjecture means guess without proof. Okay. First we can guess in the mathematics and then we could prove later. Okay. That is we are using the Euclid's lemmas. Okay. So one of the lemma is part is less than the whole. So this is the part. This is the whole thing. I divide it into four parts. So part is always less than the whole. Whole is greater than the part. That is the lemma. So every time, everyone, we can accept the point without proof. After that, we can prove it. Okay. 1 by 4, this is the less compared to the whole part, like that. So conjecture, we can utilize. We can utilize in the constructing mathematical knowledge. Hypothesis have a role in the construction of mathematical knowledge. Okay, hypothesis we can use for using the construction of mathematical knowledge. The notion of argumentation is central to mathematics. Argumentation, false or true. Okay, so we can give the proof. So argumentation also correct. This one is do not is given, therefore this is wrong. Okay, answer is second one. Come to the next one. 35 is, which of the following is desirable strategy for assessing students' learning in mathematics? So which one is the desirable strategy? Students' justification of their responses should be important. Basis of should be an important basis of assessment. Correct. Okay. So we are getting the responses from student. From that only we can justify our teaching. Okay. So which one is the correct strategy? Suppose I am giving the lecturer method only for one chapter. Okay. The response is poor means that is totally wrong. We have to give some other strategy we have to use. Okay. Activity method or any other method. Visually are using the geoboard something. So figures we can use and then identify it. Like that we can change our strategy. Okay, this is the correct one. Development of mathematics vocabulary should not be the basis of assessment. Okay, this is not correct. Same task should be given to all students. No. Students' incorrect answer should be ignored. No, this is also wrong. Yeah, we never ignore the answers, okay. From the answer, how to get the correct one, we always explain to the children, okay. Come to the next one. 36. For the given figure to be a triangle, the condition is that the union of three line segments is, okay. So, three line segment given is, three line segment is given. It makes the triangle. Okay. Union of three line segment. Okay. So only both necessary and sufficient or neither necessary nor sufficient. Necessary, not sufficient or sufficient but not necessary. So first I understand what is it necessary and a sufficient condition. Suppose I am taking one condition P to Q. Okay. That is the necessary condition, and then Q to P means that is sufficient condition. okay, suppose I want to see a drama, okay, drama, here tickets, and buying the tickets, and then they admit, and then they are allow me to enter the cinema hall, okay, ticket to entrance, entering the cinema hall, P to Q, that is the necessary condition, okay. Suppose already I am entering in the cinema hall, already I am in the cinema hall, so I have a ticket, that is Q to P, okay. This is necessary condition, this is sufficient condition. So here three lines are given, they are union to make a triangle, okay, that is the necessary condition, necessary, P to Q, but that is not a sufficient condition, okay, we need more than 3 points, okay, only three line means in the order, in that order, union of three lines, okay, so three lines we can get a triangle, but not only three lines we need, okay, so three more, one more angles also should be given. If what about the angles underneath, they are under straight line means it won't make a triangle, therefore three lines to triangle means that is a necessary condition but not a sufficient condition. Side with the angle is given means that is also the sufficient condition, okay, P to Q, that is necessary, Q to P, then only it is sufficient. Okay, reverse order also it should be true. Here it is neither necessary nor sufficient condition. Next one, consider the following statement. Four statements are given, A, B, C, D. B is the inverse of A. Inverse means 1 by B. B is the inverse of A. B equal to 1 by A, that is like the reciprocal something. D is a contrapositive, I am explaining the only term, okay. Contrapositive means suppose P to Q, the statement is true, okay. P to Q, negative of Q implies negative of P, this is contrapositive. Contraposition, that is contrapositive always says, it is contraposition, okay. Suppose P implies Q, this is a direct method, I am taking P as it is, I am proving Q means P to Q. I am using the contrapositive, contraposition method means negative of Q, I prove negative of P means, that is the statement, not we are adding, this one is represent not. You can write here not Q implies not P. Means P equal to Q only. That is another type of statement. P equal to Q, direct proof. Suppose I want to prove P equal to Q means I can prove negative of Q implies negative of P means I prove P equal to Q only. That is contraposition of A. Converse we know. Okay. A to B means B to A. Okay. That is the converse of the statement. Here n is even, n squared is even, okay. N squared is not even, n is not even. B is a contraposition of A, but they are not given, okay. N squared is even, then n is even. This is a converse of A, clearly we can see here. Okay, P to Q, here Q to P, that is converse, converse of A. Come to the next question. Which of the following teaching learning resources mathematics cannot be used in the visually challenged students, not using. We can't use for visually challenged. So tiles means the small pieces we are using for activities, okay. Tiles, small pieces of cardboard, we can use the dies or that are all we call tiles. Okay, for algebraic expression also I have done one activity by using the ties. So that is they can touch and understand the activity. That is visually challenged person can use. Geo board is also, that is a board with points. Okay, they can join and understand the quadrilateral, square, rectangle like that. That is the geo board. That is also they can understand. Taylor abacus. That is also they can feel and understand. Touch and feel. Okay. What about geo board? GeoZebra. GeoZebra is a graph. Okay. So graph, visually they can show the figures. Okay. Circle, rectangle, triangle like that. So visually challenged people can't use GeoZebra. Okay. This one is correct. Come to the next question. Which of the following statement is true? Which one is true? Intuition has no role generating mathematics knowledge. No. Intuition has a role. Okay. We are inducing something, we can prove also. Mathematical statement can be conditionable. Okay, this is possible. Next, mathematics consists of all theorems proved in the mathematics books. No, not like that. Okay, so many real life problems also there. We are doing daily life. We are using the daily life problems. Okay, a person good in arithmetic computations also good in mathematics and vice versa. Not necessary. Okay, so the answer is, mathematical statement is conditional. Okay, come to the next question. Okay, I will spell it from here. 40. Which of the following statement not correct regarding differently abled of dyslexia in mathematics? Okay, so dyslexia means reading disorder, not a writing. Digraphia means writing. Dyslexia means reading disorder only in language. They can do mathematics very well. Okay. Disorder in languages. Suppose they are reading vas instead of sa. They are confused with the letters. So reading problem. So dyslexia children may have difficulty in writing down their ideas in systematic, organized manner. No problem in writing. So this is wrong. Dyslexia impacts only language learning, not mathematics learning. Statement is not correct. Okay. Okay. Third one. Dyslexia has an impact in the person coordination of words, verbal and spatial aspects. Okay. Visual patterns in mathematics help to overcome difficult experiences by dyslexia children. So our question is, which is not correct? Which one is not correct? Not mathematical learning. This one is not correct. Okay. Verbal and subtle of numbers. Okay. They won't affect these things. A pattern in the help overcoming difficulties, dyslexia children are poor. So, it affect, okay, it only for the language only, but it affect the mathematical learning also. Okay, this is not as given. Therefore, answer is 2. Come to the next question. The number of distinct prime factors of largest 6-digit number. Okay. What is the largest 6-digit number? This is the largest 6-digit number. Okay. We need a prime factor. So we start with the 3. Okay. So 3 means 3 threes are 9. 3. Okay. Again 3. 1. So it is divisible by 11. How can I know? Because if you add the odd digits and subtract the even digit, you will get 0. Therefore, it is divisible by 11. 1, 2, 3, sum of the number is 3, so it is divisible by 3. 3, 3 is a 9, remainder 1, 3, 3 is a 9, 2, 6, and then 7. It is divisible by 7. 4481. This is the 13th table. So the question is prime factors, different prime factors. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 factors. Okay. Come to the next question. So 42. If the 8 digit number, this is the 8 digit number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 digit, divisible by 88, what is the value of x minus y, x and y? Some options are given. Okay, the same question we have done in the AWS, previous year question paper also. So we can expect in the exam. So understand the concept. It is a 8 digit number is given, 1, 7, 9, x, 0, 9, 1, 1. Okay. So divisible by 88. So it is divided by 88. What are the factors of 88? 2 into, can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 11. So factors are 211. So divided by 88 means it is divisible by 211. So what is the condition? A number is divisible by 2. So the unit digit must be 0 or even number. So y must be 0 or 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, these are the possibility for y. Now we have to find the x only. So next condition is divisible by 11. So consider the add digits. What are the add digits? Y plus 9 plus x plus 7. So 16 plus x plus y. What about the even digit? 1 plus 0, 10, 11. Subtract it. Once again add it. 1 plus 0, 10. 1 plus 9, 10. 10 plus 1, 11. Here it is y plus 9, x, 7. So 16. So here the difference is x plus y plus 5 equal to 0 or 11. Should be 0 or 11. Okay. So 11, 0 is not possible because x plus y we can't put minus 5. So x plus y can be 6. X plus y can be 6 because total should be 0 or 11. So the condition is we got x plus y equal to 6. X have these values. Okay. So first I am taking, so I am separate into x and y. Okay. I have a condition x plus y equal to 6. First I put y equal to 0. Okay. Y equal to 0. If you put y equal to 0, what about x minus y? 0 means x should be x. X minus y. If I am putting y equal to 0, this implies x will be 5. Okay. X is 0. X is, y is 0. Therefore, x equal to 6 from this equation. What about x minus y? 6 minus 0 equal to 6. There is no option 6 in the condition 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 is not here. So no need to put y equal to 0. That is not in the option. This is wrong. Come to y equal to 2. That is meaning is I am putting y equal to 0 means x value 6. Difference is also 6. No 6 is here. Therefore y equal to 0 not necessary. That is not the correct answer. Y equal to 2. Come here y equal to 2. So y equal to 2 means x may be 4. So difference is 2. So I can check. It is in the option also. So put in the answer. I am considering here it is x, here it is y. So we have to check whether it is divisible by 2 and 11. Okay. So check the values 1, 7, 9, 4, 0, 9, 1, 2. Okay. So 2 is an even number, therefore it is divisible by 2. We have to check for 11 only. So add digits, even digits. So for add digits 2 plus 9, 11, 15, 22. Even digits 1, 10, 11. So the difference is 11. Therefore, it is divisible by 11. Therefore, this option is correct. X equal to 4, Y equal to 2. The difference is 2. The answer is 41. Okay. Come to the next question. A, B, C is given. Which of the following is true? So it is in the descending order. So we have to find the value of distance. So two ways we can find the correct answer. Okay, descending order. And three numbers are given. What are the numbers? 11 by 13, 15 by 13, 13 by 14. Okay, these three numbers are given. We have to compare. So normal, what is the normal method? We always do the LCM. What is it, LCM? If you compare any number, fraction, the denominator should be same. So by using the equivalent fraction, we are making into same denominator. So this can be written as, I am multiplying rest of these two. I am not changing the question. Same question, I am multiplying with the same type of number, 17, 14, 17, 14. So the here you don't need to find the value of the denominator, only multiply the numerator. 4, 6, 1, 8. This one is same as it is. Second number, 15 by 17. So 15 into, I want these two numbers, 13, 15. So the answer is multiply these three things. Same number. Third one, 13 by 15. So I want remaining two number. So 2730 divided by the same number. Okay. So what is the order? 2, 6, 1, 8. Second number is 15 by 17. Third is 13 by 14. 1 minute. 13 by 14. Okay, 13 by 14. 15, 13, 14. This is 17, 13, 15. Because I multiplied already. For time consuming, I am writing the direct answer. Okay. Otherwise, I will show the multiplication again. Okay. 15, 13, 17 means 2, here the multiplication is 2, 7, 3, 0, here the multiplication is 2, 8, 7, 3. Okay. So it is in the increasing order. This one is less compared to this one. This is less than this one. It is in the decreasing order. Answer is the first option. Okay. This is the first method. But I always using the, I used to use this method. What is that? Normal division. 11 by 13. Okay, it is very less time. If you are 11 by 13 means 0.84. 13 by 14 means 0.9. And then 15 by 17 means 0.88. So compare these three numbers. So 0.84 is less than this one. This one is less than this one. This is the order. So this is the order. You can use that. This two method you can use. Okay. Suppose I am not good in counting the decimal means, don't use using the LCM. No, I am good in decimal point. I can divide the numbers means you have to use this one. Okay. Come to the next question. 34. Some algebraic expression is given. You have to find the value of k. Normal addition only, okay. What is given? 0.139 plus 0.75, 2.105. You have to add these three numbers, okay. If you add these three, you will get 2.994. Okay. And then second one is multiply these two, 1.001. 1, 1. So normal multiplication. First without a decimal, you multiply it and put the decimal. If you multiply in these two without a decimal point, we will get 11011. I am counting the decimal after the 0.1234. Put the 0.1234. 1.1011. So the question is, subtract this 2.994, 1.1011. So you have to add one more zero. If you subtract this one, you will get 1.8929. But this is given, this is equal to 2 minus k. We have to find the value of k. So take the number one side and then variable one side. So k equal to 2 minus means 0, 0, 0. So if you subtract, you will get 0.107. The answer is 1071. Come to the next question. This is A, B. Then which of the following does not lie between A and B? So this represents the number line. Okay. So A is minus 3 by 4. Minus 3 by 4 means we know 7.75. Okay. It is a negative value. So we are meant like left side. 0.75. 5 by 6. 5 by 6 means 0.83, positive number. In between, 0 is here. Okay, so compare the first two value. Minus 2 by 5 means 20 by 5, that is 0.4 minus. So 0.4 means it's somewhere like that. 0.4. So it is lies between A and B. Okay, minus 7 by 9. Minus 7 by 9 means 0.89. 0 point, here it is minus sign is here, so this side, minus 0.89, it is not lies between A and B. Rest of the number also we will check, 0, 0 is lies between these two number, minus half, so here is the minus 0.5. So only this number is lies outside the limit, okay, in between these two, this number is not lies between A and B. So the answer is minus 7 by 9. So I hope all the question clear. Thank you dear teacher. Please watch all my videos. If more such videos, please subscribe my channel. Support my channel. Once again, thank you and all the best for your exam.